What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Golf Simulator Videos. We're back today with a really exciting video because so many people have been reaching out asking if we were going to cover the Flightscope Mevo Plus with the new Fusion tracking and the Pro package that adds a ton of club data. Well, that's what we're here to do today. Let's go ahead and get started. All right, guys, so the first thing that I want to go over is just to talk a little bit about the Fusion tracking technology along with what the Pro package brings to the table. The Fusion tracking actually takes the internal camera of the Flightscope Mevo Plus, pairs it with the radar tracking for that fusion ability to increase accuracy. So it's actually going to use that camera. And from my understanding of what I've listened to Flightscope talk about, sounds like this is really going to help a lot with the putting and chipping, but they are utilizing that fusion tracking for all shots. But just understand that you may see the best improvement as far as like in putting and chipping, which a lot of people wanted to see increase accuracy on. Now today we're going to go out and we're going to demonstrate the Pro package, which includes a ton of additional data. So we'll be using the Fusion technology, which is actually included for free for all current Flightscope Mevo Plus users or anybody buying it in the future. That is a firmware update along with software update, and that is going to be included for everybody, no additional charge, where the Pro package is a $1,000 retail add-on, but includes a ton of parameters that you're not going to have with the standard Flightscope Mevo Plus. Now, real quick before I move on, if you're looking to purchase a Flightscope Mevo Plus, you're watching this video, make sure you shoot me an email because I'm going to pair you up, make sure you're getting the best price, but also anything else you're looking for, enclosures, projectors, all that type of stuff. I want to get you the best price available. Also, my partners, they have the highest level of customer service. That's why I've picked them. Make sure you shoot me an email and I can get you hooked up. But let's talk a little bit about this Pro package here. So you're now going to get club path, face to path, face to target, vertical swing plane, horizontal swing plane, low point, dynamic loft, vertical descent angle, curve, speed profile, and acceleration profile. So this is this D-plane data set that so many instructors talk about, you know, club fitters may be using. It's really cool that you're getting this from a consumer level type unit. You know, we're not talking about a $20,000 launch monitor. This has a retail price of $19.99. So if you're adding on that additional club data, you're talking about $3,000. That's still a very low price point considering everything that it offers, both indoor and outdoor. So I say without any further ado, we go ahead and we jump out to the FS Golf app I have hooked up here. I'm using my iPad Pro, and I've always pointed out to people in the past, I love how the iPad Pro, when you connect it to a projector, is almost a full 16 by 10 setting because of its high resolution and format. So it's really nice if you're looking to use FS Golf indoor, you can do that with your iPad Pro like this. So let's go ahead and set my phone down. I'm just gonna grab a 9 iron, which I have it set on. I think that'll be perfect for examples. It's a little bit easier for me, you know, just to get some clean shots off and show you guys some different shot shapes. What I'm going to try to do is hit a couple normal shots, hit a couple heavy draws, heavy fades, so you guys can pay attention to that club path and face to path. Those are the two data points I like to look at when I'm trying to control ball flight at all. All right, so I think that it's one of those things where if you have a Flightscope Mevo Plus and you do decide to get all of this data, you probably want to reach out to your local instructor or coach, see if they're willing to, maybe you can bring your Flightscope Mevo Plus to your next lesson. You can take some shots. They can work with you on understanding all of the data so you can see why that ball is taking off a certain direction and maybe curving a certain direction. Obviously, your path and your face are major controls to that. So it's fun working on those, especially when you have all this data available now. So let's just go ahead and fire off kind of a normal shot first, where I just kind of stand square to the ball, try to keep my path and my face, you know, somewhat, you know, similar.
Carry is, and by doing that,
you'll see that I get
yards.
A very straight ball
Ready.
Flight. Okay, so just nice smooth swing. You can see I was able to keep my club path 0.9 to the right, so just a tiny bit inside out, and then my face to path, you'll see there was 1.2 to the left, caused just a tiny bit of left curvature on that ball, but a nice smooth shot overall. And you can see that, you know, my goal of what I thought I was doing and what I felt like I was doing gave me the result here with the Flightscope Mevo Plus. So next up, I'm just gonna hit a little bit of a draw. So if I was trying to get maybe a little more out of my 9 iron, I tend to hit a draw depending on where the pin is located on the green. So this is gonna have more of an inside out path with a closed face.
carry is 100.
You can see that ball start off to the right and then come back to the left. Obviously, my club path was a little exaggerated there, showing 10 degrees to the right and then 9.9 to the left for face to path. All right. Now, if I were to want to hit a fade, which is kind of my nemesis, I love fades. I think it's a very controllable ball flight. I've been trying to get better at hitting fades. Then I would stand a little bit left here and try to get this club working this way, a little, you know, out to in, and you know, keeping that face obviously, you know, to where I want it. That way I can actually get it starting on the right direction, and then that out to in helping me get that fade right spin on the ball.
All right. Is 120.
So I actually, I hit that little fat. So you're going to see that my club path wasn't that great. My face to path 3.6 to the left. So let's go ahead and try to make a little smoother shot here. You can see how the carry wasn't that great. Just wasn't a good swing. But it's nice to show those bad swings so you guys can see the results that you're going to get. So let me try a little bit better here to hit this fade.
Carry is 119.1 yards.
Caught that one just a little bit fat as well, but you can see I'm starting to get my club path working to the left, 0.8 to the left. So if I can get a good swing in line here, we have everything working in our favor. I'd like to see that just a little more to the left, out to in.
Carry is 126.5 yards.
Much better. That ball's starting to work to the right. All right. So club path was 4.8 to the left, and my face was 8.1 to the right, face the path. So what I'd kind of like to do is release the club a little more for that fade, and I'd be able to keep that ball maybe just a little bit straighter when hitting a fade. Let's see if I can do that. Try to release that club head just a little more.
Carry is 128.1 yards.
I kind of did it, but I hit it thin. So 1.6 to the left, 2.8 to the right, but I hit it a little bit thin. So good examples, though. You know, I'm glad that I was able to actually hit a few fat shots. You guys could see the distance difference. You know, you can see all the number difference, you know, when I'm trying to hit these. So let's go ahead and try to hit one more here.
Carry is 132.4.
That is
yards.
What I'd like to see. 2.2 to the left, 2.8 to the right to my path, causing just a little bit of a fade on the ball. Carry of 132. You know, I would expect a fade like that anywhere from the low 130s to the mid 130s, and then I'm squeezing probably a 140 carry. To even 145, I'm taking light swings right now. But when I hit a draw, I can definitely get a lot more distance out of it. So why don't we hit one more draw? Try not to exaggerate it too much.
Carry is 140.1 yards.
Didn't release that face as much as I like to see. You can see the carry, obviously, 140. If I were to, you know, be able to grab a hold of that a little bit more, I can get it up to 145. Now I'm warming up a little bit, you know. So I'd like to see my angle of attack a little better than that. Usually coming down in the ball a couple degrees, that wasn't the best. So I'll try to hit one more for you guys. Love to know what you guys think. You know, please comment below any questions that you have. I've only had the Flightscope Mevo Plus Pro package now for like a day. So I've just started to mess around with it. I'll do more. I'm going to make sure that I go out and I test E6, TGC, you know, third-party software like that. Awesome Golf, they've integrated everything in there. You know, that way we can kind of do both, you know, the fusion tracking with the chipping and putting, then also the Pro package that's being integrated as well.
Carry is 135.
Just a tiny bit behind the ball on these, and it's, you know, it's killing my distance, but it's great to see. You know, I've obviously got that in to out, didn't release the club face as much, and I'm sure because I was hitting behind the ball, you know, that caused that face, you know, to kind of stay open and not release the way I wanted it to.
Carry is 138.1 yards.
There we go. I got a little more on that one.
Ready.
I'm just not getting the distance because these aren't, you know, that, you know, clean hit that I'd like to see. All right, let's do one more. That was better.
Carry is 141.5 yards. Open.
141 carry, ready. Not closing that face down. You can see I was 1.4 into out, and I left that face a little open to my path, you know, causing that ball to push. And I could feel it, you know, so it's good to see. Let's see if I could release this one a little more.
Carry is 125.
I released it
yards.
More. I caught a little, you know, ready. Fat behind the ball. And all right. Just I wanna show you guys one really crisp draw so you can see how much distance you can get out of it. And I'm just not making the best swings today.
Carry is 140.8 yards.
Bit. 140 ready. Carry. So I'm getting closer. A lot of good examples. All right. If I can stay down in this ball and actually release the way I want.
Carry is 145.8
yards. I just didn't
yards.
Push it over as much as I'd like to ready. See. But at least I'm getting up to that 145 carry that I told you guys, you know, capable of, and with that little bit of a draw. So kind of what I like to see out of my 9-iron, being able to hit 145 is a good distance, being able to fade the ball, take distance off, you know, work it both ways, and, you know, see the results. I even got the angle of attack a little better now. So, you know, coming from, you know, just kind of warming up there with a few shots, hitting a couple fat shots, I really feel like we got a wide range of demonstrations here. What I want to show you guys is that now I can review everything over here. So if I wanted to show all my shots, I can do that from this perspective. There's even a 3D ball flight. If I want to watch the ball that I just hit in the air, you can see it going left of the target line. You can do that easily, all right? And then you can actually do a perspective from the side. Here you go right here. And you can even watch all of the flights at once. I think that's pretty cool. So see how I was getting better trajectory as I was hitting the ball a little better. Here you go. You can watch all those from a top view. All right, and then you can even see groupings if you wanna see groupings. So it's gonna show you your dispersion. So a lot of cool options there, you know, as you're messing with FS Golf. The additional data parameters, if we scroll over, face to target, smash factor, height, flight time, spin loft, roll, total, lateral, shot type, D-loft, descent, V-plane, horizontal plane, low point, and curve distance. All of those are in there. And if you wanted to look at those for each shot, you can do that. Just hit the arrow down in the lower left, all right? And you can easily see all of that additional data. So if you're getting into all that deep data, it's all there if you want it. You can even go up and you can, you know, do a dashboard of just data if you want to. A lot of different, there's a table of data you can look at. There we go, table. So there's all ready. Your tables as we hit our different shots. A lot of cool things. You can obviously share it, whether it be Facebook, Instagram, email, all that stuff. There's a lot of different options inside the software. I strongly suggest that you, you know, check it out. Take a look at one of my big FS Golf update videos. I kind of show everything. I talk about that 3D ball flight, but I show how you can use the camera inside the Flightscope Mevo Plus to see your swing. That's a pretty cool feature that they have built right in, and the video comes right into FS Golf paired with all of the data, and you can share the swing and the data and stuff like that. So a lot of cool stuff. Just starting to mess around, like I said, with the Flightscope Mevo Plus and the Pro package. I definitely would like to get a full session. I'll make sure I'm fully warmed up and everything, but I thought this was really good to see a wide range. What did we take, 14 shots? I mean, you guys got to see some in the beginning, you got to see some fat shots, everything, and I was using the data to see what I was doing, and I was able to hit, you know, some better shots there towards the end, like what I was trying to do. So really cool. I hope you guys appreciate this first look video at the Flightscope Mevo Plus with Fusion Tracking and the Pro Package data. Make sure you comment below and let me know what you think. I'll make sure to have more coming soon. All right, so stay tuned.